In this video, we're going to look at the definition of inverse functions and a description of what an inverse function is. We're also going to cover a method for finding the inverse. F of x and g of x are inverse functions of each other if f in composition with g of x equals x and g in composition with f of x equals x. And I have a note here. This is for all x in the domain of both f of x and g of x. We'll see how this comes into play later. And another way of phrasing the composition is f in composition with g of x means f of g of x equals x and g of f of x equals x for the composition of g with f. And here's an example of two functions that are inverses of each other. F of x equals 2x plus 1 and g of x equals x minus 1 over 2. Let's do the f in composition with g of x first. Here we're plugging the g of x function of x minus 1 over 2 in for each x of f of x. And that means we're taking 2 times the x minus 1 over 2 and adding 1. When we do that, the 1's cancel and we end up with x. Now when we do the other composition, we're taking g of f of x. Here we're plugging the 2x plus 1 function in for the x of g of x. And the g of x function is to subtract 1 and divide by 2. When we subtract 1, the 1's cancel. We get 2x over 2, which also simplifies to x. So this verifies that f of x and g of x are inverse functions of each other. And here I have a statement. Inverse functions reverse the operations of each other in reverse order. The function f of x was to double and add 1. To reverse the steps of doubling and adding 1, we subtract 1, and then we divide by 2. Well, that's the g of x function. The g of x function was subtract 1 and then divide by 2. To reverse those operations, we double and then add 1. You're probably wondering, what is the purpose of the inverse function? Well, the inverse function recovers your x value. What I mean by that is shown in this example. Here we have a function 2x cubed minus 1 over 5. We plug 4 into this function, and we end up getting 2 times 4 cubed minus 1 divided by 5 equals 25.4. So when our x value is 4, our y value is 25.4. Well, if we plug 25.4 into our inverse function, we get back that x. And that's what I show here. The inverse function of f of x is the cube root of 5x plus 1 over 2. Because when we're reversing the operations of cubing, doubling, subtracting 1, and then dividing by 5, we have to reverse in reverse order and multiply by 5, add 1, divide by 2, and then take the cube root. Now, if that seemed a bit difficult to follow, don't worry. There's a procedure to find this inverse coming on the next page. But at any rate, we plug 25.4 into our inverse function, and look what we get back, 4, our original x value. So you might be asking, where is this used? Well, one place it is used is cryptology. The place that uses it is the National Security Agency. They use cryptology all the time to decode encrypted messages. Because encryption is a function. It takes a message, applies a mathematical formula to it, and it scrambles it into a different message. Well, to reverse that operation, we need the inverse function. And you're probably thinking, well, I'm not going to work for the National Security Agency. Where else would I use these inverse functions? Well, the place is the upcoming chapter on exponential and log functions. And here I have a function, f of x equals 10 to the x. If f of x equals 30, what would x equal? In other words, if we got a y value of 30, what would be the x value that would give us this y value? In other words, we're solving the equation 30 equals 10 to the x. The only problem with this equation is we have no algebraic way of solving for x, but we know that the inverse function of 10 to the x is the log function, or the base 10 log function. And when we plug 30 into that log function, we get 1.477121. You can do this on your calculator. Find the key that says log, plug in 30, and see what you get. You're going to get 1.477121. And this indeed is the power you place on 10 to give you 30. If you try evaluating 10 to that power, you get 30 or very, very close to it. And without the inverse function, we would have no way to solve for x. And here's the method for finding the inverse function that I mentioned. And we're going to use this method to find the inverse of f of x equals 3x cubed plus 1. The first step is to replace f of x with y. That means we're going to write this function as y equals 3x cubed plus 1. Then we're going to switch each x with each y. So now we have x equals 3y cubed plus 1, and our third step is to solve that equation for y. So we subtract 1 from both sides, we divide both sides by 3, then we cube root both sides, and we get cube root of x minus 1 over 3 equals y. Now we have a special notation for the inverse of f of x. We call it f minus 1 of x. You see the notation right here. If it were g of x, the notation would be g minus 1 of x. So we write our answer as f minus 1 of x, or inverse of f of x, equals the cube root of x minus 1 over 3. And I have a note, this procedure works since you must reverse all the operations in reverse order in order to solve for y, where y and x have been switched.